Hi there, folks. Welcome to episode 13 of I Don't Want to Hold Your Hand, the Beatles Quarantine Catalog, where I'm attempting to play all 248 Beatles songs in chronological order while we are all stuck inside. So before we get into today's huge, huge song in the catalog, I am on YouTube, I am on Instagram, I am on Venmo, in case you would like to subscribe, follow, or support the series. Thank you to everybody who's already done those things, and I hope you like today's video. So last we were with the Beatles. They had just recorded their three original tunes and 13 covers in their Decca record audition, and they were unfortunately, but fortunately, turned down by Decca Records as guitar groups were on their way out, Mr. Epstein. So now Brian Epstein has those recordings, really good recordings of his band playing, and he sent them out to other record companies. And these recordings get in the hands of George Martin, who is the head of Parlophone, which is under EMI, which is a big record label. And George likes them enough to bring the group in for an audition. So on June 6th, 1962, the Beatles walk into EMI Recording Studios, better known now as Abbey Road Studios, for the first time. 2 hours are set aside for the Beatles to have their little artist test audition. And in those 2 hours, they record four songs. They do a cover of Besame Mucho, and they do three originals. P.S. I Love You, Ask Me Why, and today's song, Love Me Do. The thing about Love Me Do is there are three versions of it. You've definitely heard one of them. You've probably heard two of these versions, but there is a third that you may not know is out there. And that is this first version that was recorded on June 6th at their audition for EMI. This early version of Love Me Do is essentially the exact same as the versions that we all know and love. The big difference is in the drums. Pete Best is still the drummer of the Beatles, and you can tell, particularly on the bridge. The version that we all know, the drum part is essentially someone to love, somebody new, right? The version that they record on June 6th with Pete Best, the drum part is like that for most of the song, but then on the bridge randomly cuts to someone to love, somebody new. Pete Best is just doing a little bit too much in a song that is otherwise very, very simple. And whether it's this or he is inconsistent rhythm at times, for one reason or another, George Martin loves the group, but he does not love Pete Best. So George Martin signs the Beatles to Parlophone, and a date is set, September 4th, 1962. They're going to come back and really record their first single. But George Martin wants to bring in a session drummer, somebody who's brought in just to make sure that this song is as good as it can be. And this is something that happened all the time. Session musicians are brought in all the time. It's still done to this day. In this case, it sort of stresses out the rest of the band, and it is decided soon after their audition that the Beatles need to move on from Pete Best and find a better drummer. And if you're interested, the version of Besame Mucho that they recorded on June 6th is also available on Anthology 1 and on YouTube. The recordings of Ask Me Why and P.S. I Love You were destroyed, which was common practice at the time, and those don't exist anywhere, sadly. So the Beatles have their first real recording day coming up, and Pete Best, for one reason or another, isn't cutting it. So they need a new drummer, and they pick a gentleman that they've met many, many times in Hamburg, in Liverpool. He's the drummer of Rory Storm and the Hurricanes, great band name. And he's even filled in for Pete when Pete Best is sick or when he couldn't make it. They even have already recorded a song together. They did a cover of Summertime, I believe. That recording was lost, but they've already recorded together, so they know this guy really well. His name is Richard Starkey, better known as Ringo Starr. We are 13 videos into this series, and we finally have John Lennon, Paul McCartney, George Harrison, and Ringo Starr in the same group, and they're going to start recording music right now. The Beatles head back to EMI on September 4th, 1962, with their new drummer to record their first single, And George Martin hands them a song called How Do You Do It? And it's not their favorite. It's a little schmaltzy, a little cheesy. It goes something like, how do you do what you do to me? I wish I knew. If I knew how you do it to me, I'd do it to you. It's kind of lame, I suppose. But the Beatles agree to record it if they get to record one of their originals as well. So their recording of How Do You Do It is on YouTube, is on Anthology 1, so you can hear it. They luckily decide to go with their original tune, Love Me Do, which they already recorded with Pete Best. So today they are going to record it with Ringo on the drums, and George Martin is still not thrilled. So on September 11th, 1962, the Beatles come back to EMI Studios and record Love Me Do for a third time. And this time, George Martin gets his way and a session drummer named Andy White plays the drums and Ringo is relegated to the tambourine. Luckily for all of us, both the September 4th version with Ringo on the drums and the September 11th version with Andy White on the drums and Ringo on tambourine, they were both released very widely. In fact, the single version of Love Me Do is the one with Ringo, and the album version on Please Please Me is the one with Andy White. How you can tell the difference is whether or not you can hear Ringo playing the tambourine. Things to listen for in this tune. It's a very appropriate. This is our first official Beatles release because we finally have Ringo, and we finally have the simple, simple drumming of Ringo that serves the song so much better than the Pete Best version does. And also, we finally get some classic John Paul harmonies. We're finally zeroing in on what the Beatles are going to sound like. On October 5th, 1962, this song would be released in the UK and the world would forever be changed. It would peak at 17 on the UK charts and then be released in the United States 2 years later and would peak at number one. So please enjoy Beatles song number 13, our first official Beatles song, Love Me Do.
Someone like you, love, love me too.